Okay, so today we are going to do a 10-story love song by the Stone Roses. Now, it's been about a month, I think, since I've done the Stone Roses, and a lot of people seem to like, whether it's my reactions or just hearing the band, it's nice to see. So anyway, I figured let's do this one today and just get going here. So let's see what this song's about. Starting off quiet. Kind of far away. A lot of drums in the right ear.
Black and broken, and you need a helping hand. When you're so much in love, you don't know just how much you can stand. When your questions go unanswered, and the silence is killing.
All right. So, okay, that was I didn't know it was over. So the Stone Roses and 10 Storey Love Song. I thought we were gonna get into a little bit of psychedelic sound at the end there. I thought it was gonna keep going a little bit. It reminded me a lot of like a psychedelic kind of band. But anyway, yeah, I like that song, I gotta say. Like I said, it was very nice, I thought. It was just another song where, like I've said before, Ian Brown's vocals they aren't harsh. They're not grating or anything. It's just I don't know how to explain his signature sound. Just, his distinctive voice, I guess I could say, is what it is for me. It's just, when it's Ian Brown, he's got that soft voice and he's got a little bit of, I don't know, maybe it must be, it could be his accent. I haven't actually heard him speak, but yeah, it's just, there's a little bit of something there, and it just makes me know it's Ian Brown, obviously, also because I know it's the Stone Roses. But either way, it's just, I don't know, I really like his voice anyway, like I've said before. And also, I have to say, as I said at the start, what was really coming through the headphones was the drums by Alan Wren. And I think Rennie is what they call him. But yeah, it was just, that was very apparent at the start. Again, I always liked the drums. And then what was coming over here in my left ear, my left, was John Squire's guitar. And what I've noticed also with John Squire, as apparently he wrote this song on his own, it says. But what I've noticed with John Squire is, from the songs I've heard, there's never really, a lot of light on him. There's never really, a long solo or whatever. It's just, he does very tasteful, licks and grooves, and it's just, it all fits together so well with this band. And same with, I mean, every instrument in the song, even with the bass. Again, I can't remember who the bassist is, but I remember everyone else for some reason. But yeah, it's just a very great song. Gary Mountfield on bass. Yes, okay, I just had to remember that. This was released in 1995, apparently. So yeah, it's just so much grace, I want to say. And also, like I was saying, there's almost a psychedelic feel to this song. Like, I was getting some Pink Floyd vibes, honestly. Listening not only near the end, but during kind of the start, I guess, in the middle, whatever. I guess the whole song gave me Pink Floyd vibes at some parts, and near the end there, it was just maybe like the Doors came through, just because I love the Doors so much, and that's what I kind of link with psychedelic sounds. But anyway, yeah, so that's my opinions on the song there. I thought it was just, I mean, again, I would say love's a big theme here, from, the song is 10 Storey Love Song. But yeah, it just, the lyricism here is pretty, I would say it's pretty sweet. Loving, in that way, sweet in that way. So yeah, I'll just go through some lyrics, I guess I could say, on genius.com. So it says, with the first verse, when your heart's black and broken and you need a helping hand. So there is some annotations here. Yeah, so let's just see. So, heartbroken after a breakdown in a relationship, black and broken represents a rotten feeling in his heart. He feels lost and needs a helping hand to get his life back on track. When you're so much in love, you don't know just how much you can't stand. And I mean, yeah, I feel like, maybe not everybody, but well, somebody in your life, somebody's got to love somebody at some point, even if it's a pet, even if it's a fish, a pet fish. You gotta love something. And I mean, at the end of the day, I mean, yeah, you're gonna have that person. I mean, you're gonna love so much you can't stand. Usually, it's gonna be a spouse, I would think. But anyway, when your questions go unanswered and silence is killing you, my eye is just twitching. The breakdown in the relationship frustrates him as he gets the silent treatment, and the silent treatment is never a good thing. Unable to understand the reasons behind their troubles with the questions unanswered. So yeah, when the questions go unanswered and then the silent treatment comes in, it's just a double whammy. Take my hand, baby. I'm your man. Now I get some Wham themes here. Great song by Wham. I love George Michael. Anyway, I got loving enough for two. So here, I was thinking this line made me think throughout the whole song. I think this line stuck out to me more. I don't know why. But anyway, I got loving enough for two. So it says this hints that his love is one directional. One direction. He is heartbroken, but despite his partner not loving him the same, he feels his feelings of love are large enough for both of them. So anyway, I'm getting some unrequited love themes here, I would say, if this is all right and correct here. If you hear something outside, I think somebody's window's open. I was just hearing noises. Anyway, and my dog's on the bed sleeping, so she snores. Anyway, in the chorus, 10-story love song, I built this thing for you. So when he says that, I built this thing for you, I'm thinking, like, does he mean, like, I wrote this song for you? Like, as in another way of saying this? It says, like a 10-story building, his love stands tall, and he crafted this personal song to expose himself and his vulnerability, all for his loved one in the desperate hope he may rekindle their failed love. I don't know if, because I've never gotten into, you know, Ian Brown's love life, or even if this is, well, I guess it's written by John Squire, so John Squire's love life either. So I don't know who he was seeing, but I'm guessing he's talking about somebody here from his life. So it says, there's no surefire set solutions, no shortcut through the trees. He's not sure how they can get their relationship back on track. There's no easy answer, no shortcut back to happiness. No breaching the wall that they put there to keep you from me. The divide between them possibly hints this barrier was put by someone else. So now we're getting into, no breaching the wall that was put there to keep you from me. Somebody else coming into play. Now this is reminding me, because I've been listening to more Dr. Hook. I don't know if anyone else really knows who Dr. Hook is, but they have a song, Sylvia's Mother. I think that's one of the most known songs. But that's what's reminding me of this, about how the person on the phone in Sylvia's Mother is trying to get to Sylvia, but her mother's, like, blocking him. And, so that really gives me, just because I've been listening to more Dr. Hook right now, that gives me kind of the same feeling that's going on in this song. I just wanted to say that. As you're living awake in this darkness, this everlasting night, someday soon, don't know where or when, you're going to wake up and see the light. So he's telling her, he believes that one day they'll see the light. And as it says, realize she made a mistake letting him go. So maybe one day that will happen. And then we have the chorus at the end, 10-story love song, I build this thing for you. Who can take you higher than Twin Peak Mountain Blue? And I like how that's like a question. Who can take you higher than Twin Peak Mountain Blue? Oh, well, I build a song for you and I love you true. And then it repeats. So, yeah, and that's basically all we have for this song there. I would say, this is a little bit somber. Well, like I said, the song sounded nice, but, unrequited love, somebody trying to get somebody to love them back. It's always kind of, it's a hard deal, but, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. This is another good song, and Ian Brown's voice just fits this kind of music so perfectly, these kind of lyrics, just such a soft, sweet voice, and I guess that's all I gotta say. I want to thank you for, so many people do request the Stone Roses, and it's nice to see. And the Roses, they might be a band, they probably will be a band where I go through every song in their catalog, because, they're just that good. I love their sound. So anyway, I guess that's enough from me. Thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting. Really appreciate all of the support. And I will talk to you guys again soon. And I did get a haircut. So I'll see you later. Okay.